From the Gospel of St. Luke. Just then a lawyer stood up to test Jesus. "Teacher," he said, "what must I do to inherit eternal life?" He said to him, "What is written in the law? What do you read there?" He answered, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your mind, and all your neighbor as yourself." And he said to him, "You have given the right answer. Do this, and you will live." But wanting to justify himself, he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and fell into the hands of robbers, who stripped him, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. Now by chance a priest was going down that road, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. So likewise a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, while traveling, came near him, and when he saw him, he was moved with pity. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, having poured oil, wine on them. Then he put him on his own animal, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day he took out 2 denarii, gave them to the innkeeper, and said, 'Take care of him, and when I come back, I will repay you whatever more you spend.' Which of these 3 do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of the robbers?" He said, "The one who showed him mercy." Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise."
The story we just read today is a dialogue between Jesus and a lawyer. This lawyer is a very wise and intelligent man. He studied the law and knows how to be a good Jew. I wonder what he thought about the words of Jesus in the previous chapter of Luke, where he says that certain things, a certain knowledge of God, is hidden from the wise and the intelligent. The question from the lawyer, "Who is my neighbor?" gives the impression that for him, humanity is divided into neighbors and non-neighbors. There are us and them. Does the lawyer ask Jesus for a rule in order to know who he should love and who not? You might have noticed that Jesus does not enter into this discussion. His parable does not answer the question directly because it is not a good question. So what then does Jesus try to tell the lawyer? Let's have a closer look at the different persons in our parable. The priest and the Levite are religious Jews who serve God in the temple. They know the law and their religion. Samaritans are considered by them as heretics and enemies because they don't observe the law. All 3 meet the same injured man. The priest and the Levite see him but choose to ignore him. Their kind of intellectual approach of religion and the law makes them see the victim only as a risk of them becoming impure in the eyes of the law. Their eyes and their hearts are blind to his suffering. But the Samaritan is moved with pity. And the word used in Greek indicates that he is not just feeling sorry. It is much more. Something is moving inside him. The pain of the other does not leave him cold as stone. It's a strong feeling of compassion. Literally, compassion means taking part in the suffering of someone else. Compassion is not something of the mind, but comes from the deepest center of our being. It makes the Samaritan see with the eyes of his heart. He sees a human being like himself, not just someone half dead, but first of all, someone still alive. Compassion makes him see also the needs of the injured man. And what is more, he feels responsible for the well-being of the other, and this responsibility makes him do something. He spontaneously responds to what he sees by doing what he thinks is necessary. He gives his time and does what he can, and without bothering about the consequences for himself. And we discover that he does not do it alone. He asks the innkeeper for help. Together they give the injured man the care he needs. In short, compassion is this: to see, to be moved, to get moving. To move literally closer towards the other. Yes, compassion makes all the difference. Probably it sounds very disturbing to Jewish ears that it is a Samaritan who showed compassion and who made himself close to the injured man. But by calling the Samaritan the one who has showed pity, the lawyer shows that he has understood that becoming a neighbor does not depend on who you are. From Jesus' question that concludes this parable, we understand that what matters is how we become a neighbor to others and how we love. But there is one more thing. Something that I think does come back to the original question of the lawyer, who is my neighbor? The injured man is perfectly anonymous. We don't know who he is or where he comes from. It could be another priest, another Samaritan. It could also be another bandit, a friend or an enemy. It could be anyone. For the Samaritan, his identity is not important. He recognizes him simply as his brother. Compassion does not care about differences between people and is therefore able to build bridges. So the invitation of Jesus in this text is double. We are to become neighbors ourselves, and secondly, we are to become a neighbor to anyone. We have discovered in this parable that being a priest or Levite, or knowing a lot about faith or theology, does not mean that we know automatically how to love others. All the way through his dialogue with Jesus, we see the intelligent lawyer discover how compassion is the key to a good understanding of the commandment to love God and your neighbor as yourself. He understands that without compassion, receiving eternal life is going to be difficult. Perhaps it's compassion, this seeing with the heart, that enables little children and the poor in spirit to understand things that the wise and the learned do not understand.
Questions for the sharing in small groups. Who are the people who are strangers to you, different, with whom you have little in common, or whose views you don't share or understand? What can help to really see them and do a step towards them? Is there a situation in which you experience compassion? Have you had the experience of having someone show compassion to you when you did not expect that of them? How did this compassion become concrete? Could you give an example of a situation in which you have acted out of compassion? What made you go towards the other person? Or what could keep you from doing something that a neighbor would do?